Recently, Amazon removed the option of using authenticator, all right, authenticator to get OTP from their platform to log in into your Amazon KDP account or the profile section, all right? I had this difficulty when I wanted to access the profile section of my Amazon KDP to answer task interview, all right? And in this video, I will guide you on how to solve the OTP issue. Whether you want to access the account section, that's the profile section of your Amazon KDP account, or you want to log in for the first time, follow me. Let me put you through on how you do that. Okay, in my own case, I was able to log in for the first time because I have saved my login details on my web browser. But if you are just trying to log in to kdp.amazon.com, and you're finding it difficult, don't worry, it's still the same thing, the process is the same. Okay, so here I captured some parts of my dashboard for security reason. I don't want to cut for privacy sake, I don't want to capture everything. So once you are here or you are trying to log in my own case, I'm here, I want to access this your account section. Okay, so click on this your account section. All right, so you'll be taken to a new page. Okay, this is the new page you'll be taken to. All right, exactly something that looks like this. If you are trying to log in for the first time, this is still the page you are going to be taken to. Maybe you bought a new device and you want to access your account from that new device. Okay, so this will state parts of your phone number with this text option selected, all right, with this text option selected. Okay, then say text me at my number ending in so. This is my own number, all right, part of my own number. Then the next step you need to take is to click on this send OTP. Be following step by step, send OTP. Once you click on this send OTP, you may not get that OTP. The network that has this issue mainly in Nigeria are Airtel and Glo. These are my personal experience. Okay, now that you do not get the OTP after some time, the next step you need to take is to click on this option here, two-step verification account recovery. That is what you're going to click on. All right, two-step verification account recovery. You'll be taken to a new page. Okay, this is the new page you'll be taken to, and it's informing you on what this is all about. It says recover your account after two-step verification fails. If two-step verification fails and you can't access your account, you can try to recover your account. All right, so it's going to tell you a lot of things about what you need to do, what the steps you need to take. All right, so the next step you need to take to save time is to click on this link, two-step verification account recovery, this link here. Okay, so when you click on this link here, you'll be taken to another new page. All right, you'll be landed on this page, and it's going to tell you some things about this two-step verification account recovery. To regain access to your account, you will need to verify your identity. To do so, you will need to provide a picture or a scan or photo of government issued identity document, all right, acceptable form of government issued identification include a state issued driver's license, a state ID card, and so many other options. All right, now they will quote your email address here as well. So here my own is hidden for security reason. All right, then what you need to do in this case, if you are a Nigerian, all right, listen very well, get the new NIN digital card. I repeat, the digital card, the new one. All right, let me show you how it will look like. First is that you can go to NIN office and get it. If you cannot get to NIN office and get it, you may have somebody that works in NIN office. Tell him to generate the soft copy for you. All right, Once it generates the soft copy for you and sent to you maybe on WhatsApp or on email, then you go to a business center and print it in ID card form. If you don't know any person you are going to contact, leave a comment in this comment section. I have someone I served with when I was a core member. So he does that. So I will link his phone number or his Facebook account. You contact him, he will do that for you. All right. Then once he generates the soft copy, I think it cost 2,000 naira as of when I did mine. Then once he print it, once he send it to you, you print it on ID card, on plastic ID. Let me show you how it will look like on plastic ID. Okay. Okay. On plastic ID, it will look like this. I hit some information here. All right. This place is going to contain QR code, which Amazon will use to verify the details on this. On this your ID card when you print it out. Okay, this is how it's gonna look like. Okay, this one will contain your face. Mine is hidden for security reason. Okay, so it will have this information, the date of issue. All right, now before you snap this, there's something you need to do. National identity number. You have to find something, use something to cover this. Amazon will also tell you that. KDP will tell you that. Find a paper like this and cover this NIN number. They say you should do that, all right? Then once you cover this NIN number, snap the front, place it on a black background. You can see this is a dark background. It makes the thing to scale through fast. On a black background, place it on that ID card, plastic ID on a black background, and then you snap, all right? Once you snap that, make it clean, and then you send it to your PC if you're using PC to accept to access your account, or you leave it on your phone. Then turn the back copy, the back parts of the ID and snap as well on a black background. But in some cases, they will require the front copy, all right? The front part of the ID, all right? But you know, things change on Amazon KDP. Tomorrow they may come up and tell you that they need the front and back, all right? But in my own case, I scanned only the front to them, okay? So let's get back to the page we were before. So once you have finished snapping that ID, come here and click on choose file. All right. Once you click on choose file, navigate to that ID card you snap, the plastic ID you snap, then pick it and then have it here. Once you have it here, click on submit. At that point, this submit button will be clickable. On clicking on this submit button, wait. A new page will show. They will tell you that it may take up to 2 days, 1 to 2 days for them to verify your ID. All right. But in my own case, it just took 10 minutes. So you need to be checking your email account linked to this Amazon KDP. Check your email. All right. It may come fast. Okay. After 10 minutes, after 5 minutes, check. Okay. Once it is successful, you will get an email. The image will read like this. Hello. Thank you for contacting us about the two-step verification of your account, your Amazon account. We have confirmed that the two-step verification has been deactivated and your account access has been restored using the document you presented. Okay? So now this has gone through, but if yours fail, they will tell you that it failed. All right, it failed, and you have to start the process out fresh. But if you take the step I informed you, you'll get everything correct. So what you need to do once you get this email is then go to kdp.amazon.com and sign in. All right, once you try signing in, they will try sending you email to some code to your email address. All right, so you can see they will send you email telling you that they have sent you code to your email. You should insert the code. Okay. So once you insert the code here, click on submit. Okay. Once you click on submit, you'll be taken to another new page. Okay. This is the new page you'll be taken to. Listen very attentively here. On this new page, the US country will be selected by default. Because you're coming from Nigeria, for instance, click here and select Nigeria as your country. Okay. Then once you select Nigeria, plus 234 will be assigned. Then you start entering your phone number. If, for example, your phone number is 080-112-344. or 080-344-222. Start from 80 on. Remove the first zero, okay? Now, please, the phone number you're going to enter here should be a different phone number. If you used Airtel or Glo, don't insert it here again. Find an MTN number and enter here. MTN goes fast. Find an MTN number and enter here. That MTN number may belong to your mom, to your dad, or to your grandma, someone that is not using KDP. Or you can even go and get a new MTN line. Insert that number here. Listen, I said MTN, no other network. Then once you insert the number here, click on send OTP. That OTP will be sent to that phone number. Then you enter it in a space provided for you to sign in fully. Okay, so that is that. Once you sign in fully, you can now access your account section or even your dashboard if that is what you are interested in, your bookshelf. All right, it's as simple as that. Once you follow this step, you get everything done. And if your interest is to answer a task interview, you answer your task interview and move on. I believe you find this content helpful. Please, if it does help, consider subscribing to this channel. All right, hit the like button. And also, leave a comment. If you have some questions, all right, in respect to this OTP issue on Amazon KDP, just drop that in the comment section, whether from Nigeria or from any other country, okay? Hit the like button, the one that points up, so that YouTube recommend this content to more people. Please don't forget, okay? You can watch this video here to learn how to make more sales on Amazon KDP. Thank you, and see you some other time.